Mini Chapter 31, Amber stalks Dud at work. Without warning, Amber enters Dud's office in the Avenue of the Stars Tower. Facing the other direction, a seated Dud hears the door open behind him and says, "Rhea, get me a cup of tea, pet." Amber steps across the room towards him and speaks Jaymi's thoughts aloud with that charismatic, twinkling menace that's so inimitably Amber's. "How I should pity any children of a monkey who devotes his little monkey years to creating what you create." Dud wheels around in his chair, struggles to place the identity of the man staring down into him with that familiar wide-set fluidity of humour in his eyes, but can only splutter while Amber continues in the tone of a spellbinding lullaby that cannot be interrupted. "Look at the elements of you I'm expressing hatred for. Find that hiding place in your head where you have the clearest and widest view of humanity. It may resemble a mountain lodge. Sit inside it by the window with everything quiet, and look through the glass at all the people you've made things for. From up here in this lodge, don't you hate those things you made? If you don't, you ugly monkey, then perhaps you're in the wrong lodge, or maybe you're not a man at all, but a big toe, who won't have seen much." He stops speaking, but his close-up gaze into Dud's monkey face continues unblinking, backed up by Jamie's gaze down through Amber's eyes. "Who the fuck are you?" gabbles one of the holes in the monkey's face, while the other two holes snivel in sympathy with the first. "How does it feel to be a sluggish deadweight? Is that working out well for you? Less a personality and more an assemblage of shortfalls," Amber smiles. "Well, the sight of you makes my skin crawl, like the sound of clinker scraped on concrete, or the rubbing of hands caked in dry mud, so I think I'll slip away now. Thanks for having me." Saying this, Amber reaches forward, deftly forces the other's jaws apart, and pushes a large dead cockroach into Dud's mouth. And with that, he and his creator are gone. 5 long seconds later, when the last of the insect has been spat out, Dud bellows in wordless anger. He slams his fist onto a button on his desk phone to summon Rhea.